Hey guys, welcome to the Testing Academy. My name is Pramod and welcome to the 30 days of automation in testing, guys. And we are at a day 4. I hope you are following me on this learning the automation journey, right? This is an important journey. We are basically learning new concept related to the automation testing. If you are new, beginner, or even if you are a medium level, right? This 30 days challenge can definitely change your life in a such a way that you will understand new concept related. All right, so today's topic is about the automation testing tool. So I'm going to discuss about the top automation tools of 2020, right? All right, guys. So if you have been following me, if you want to download, if you want to basically see all the challenges, you can open this link basically, which you can see all the tasks that we are going to do in the 30 days. If you want to have a discussion, if you want to go to the club.ministry.com where they have done this 30 days of automation testing, you can go to that link. If you have any doubt, you can ask me here. And if you want to learn more about the automation testing, I will recommend you to go to the testingacademy.com, guys. Right. So let's start with our automation testing tools. And if you see, it's a big one, right? All right. Let's go one by one. Right. So I hope that makes sense, right? So credit goes to the people who already has created the diagram. Means again, it's a very wonderful diagram. So I just wanted to share that thing. So we'll talk about the automation testing tools, guys. We have Selenium, Catalan Studio, UFT, Test Complete, and SOAP UI, right? So let's go one by one, how they are different and what are the major advantages and disadvantages in choosing it, right? So let me open up my pack. Right. So if we talk about Selenium is an open source tool. And if you talk about it, it is available since 2004. Means the first one was the UFT one. Means I have started my career with the UFT. I have worked with it. It's the main problem with that is that it is supported only Windows. And the problem was the VBScript, guys. Means VBScript is a very old language, which is very similar to, you can say, JavaScript and all. But yeah, that was again the UFT basically was using. And so after Selenium, most of the tools that you are seeing right now, means most of the majority, if you talk about the automation testing tools, right, majority of the people still use Selenium because it's an open source. It has because it supports multiple platforms. So we have Windows, Mac, Linux, and different versions of Linux covered. We have scripting language support, which is like Java, C Sharp, Perl, Python. So you can understand how Selenium is so powerful. Why Selenium is so powerful in that case, right? Programming skills. To make Selenium scripts, you need to understand certain programming skills. So I would say advanced skills are still required, right? So there's a new player which is called as Catalan Studio, right? Catalan Studio was launched in 2015. I have worked on it. And again, it's a paid tool, guys, and I'm gonna talk to you about this thing. So it's a paid tool. If you talk about it, it's very costly, which is like $760 per year. And similarly, you have SOAP UI, Test Complete, and UFT. They have huge fees, right? So that's one of the reason, actually. That's one of the reason people prefer to use the open source tools, because it contains so much documentation, so much better. And people love open source tools because they can find more documentation. They can discuss about the problem and all, right? So that's why, right? Test Complete, again, it supports Windows. If you talk about SOAP UI is mostly used to test the web services, right? It supports Groovy and JavaScript. If you talk about the programming skill, right? In Selenium only, we have to learn the advanced skills, right? So that's why I'm starting in the previous video, I have started this Selenium basic Hello World, right? So that's why, because in most of the tools, the programming language, or you can say, I would say advanced skills are not required. But Selenium, since most of the market, especially related to the software testing, right? Automation, right? It was acquired by Selenium, that's in that case. So I'll highly recommend you, if you are an automation beginner, start with Selenium, right? In the meanwhile, you can learn other tools. But probably Selenium with Java is like Java, Maven, and TestNG. These are the few of the tool set, or you can say stack, automation stack, that you need to focus on if you are a beginner, right? So if we talk about overall ratings, as you can see that Catalan Studio has like 651 out of we have like 4.4 rating. But I will still recommend Selenium because Selenium basically Catalan has a huge fee. So if you are a small business, small startup, or not a big company, you cannot afford much of these heavy tools and all, right, for automation, then definitely stick with the Selenium in that case. So if we talk about the automation tool, we have like bunch of other tools like tools, sorry, that is Telerik Test Studio, Robotium is there, right? Test Complete, I have discussed. Wattle, Visual Studio, Test Professional, UFT, we have discussed, and these things, right? So again, I'm gonna share this presentation in the link. You can read about it, but we are gonna stick with Selenium in that case, right? Because that is again, we want to learn those things which are basically working in the market so that we can have some great opportunities, right? That's what we get. So there is I want to discuss about this very interesting survey that is done by Catalan Studios. And if you see about it, like they have taken some bunch of sample of the 100 users, and as you can see, like 80% of the people are still using Selenium, and people are starting to use Catalan Studio, but due to the licensing and all, they are just not using it. Other than that, people are preferring APM for mobile automation, Cucumber, right? Robotium, Test Complete, and you can see, right? So this is a very interesting survey which basically talks about why Selenium is important, right? In the previous part, we have discussed about the advantages and disadvantages of Selenium. So stick with the Selenium, and we're gonna learn in this 30 days of journey, we're gonna learn about the Selenium basic concepts related to it, and definitely that can help you to learn the automation, right? All right. So thanks a lot for watching. I hope you have learned something new about the automation testing tools, right? If you haven't watched the previous tutorial, I will recommend you to watch it, right? So in the upcoming tutorials, what we are going to do is that we are going to learn about the Selenium. We are going to learn about the basic concept related to Selenium and all, as well as we are going to learn some about the some automation concepts related to it, right? So we are going some parallelly so that we can have better understanding of it, right? I hope you are following me on this channel, and if you have any doubt, comment down below. I'll be happy to help you. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next video.